Hi, guys, this is San, like, it's literally written in my channel name. Well, first of all, I'd like to say that I'm Brazilian, which means my American pronunciation sucks and this video may contain several errors because of that, so if you are a person who has some free time to comment on what the writing and speaking errors in this video would be, I'd appreciate it. Now let's get to the shit. If you know and have watched Beavis and Butthead, you probably know that this cartoon contains things that are disgusting and disturbing, to the point that some episodes are even censored. But well, even though there are several episodes like that, the one that caught my attention the most until today was the episode Drones. This episode itself is nothing special, it's just Van Driessen going on a field trip with his class to a military base, while Beavis and Butthead are doing some shit, obviously. But what I really want to say about this episode is the reaction of the two to the Ghost and Stuff music video made by deadmau5. I know that these breaks in the middle of the episodes are not really relevant to the story of the episode, but look at.
Remember when they sent that grief counselor to talk to us? Right after, whatever his name was, died?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he was cool. He let us call him Rick.
Yeah, he, like, turned his chair backwards and rolled up his sleeves.
You know, he invited me over to his apartment for spaghetti, too.
That's kind of weird. You didn't go, did you?
Maybe, I don't really remember. Last thing I remember, I got into his van, and, he gave me some lemonade, and then the next thing I remember, I woke up under a bridge.
Are you just making this up? You never told me about this.
Now, see, that's exactly what Rick said would happen if I ever told anybody. They would say I made it up, see? He's a smart guy, that Rick.
Okay, Beavis.
You know, I think he can see into the future, too, because he also told me that my butt might hurt for a couple days. And it did. You see that? Amazing.
Yeah, this may seem a little hard to understand, but it's basically Beavis relating his experience of being drugged and raped by a school grief counselor. One of the worst parts is that the counselor told Beavis that if he told anyone, no one would believe him. Even Butthead is amazed by this fact, to the point that he considers it a lie. But there is no way that this is a lie, you know, Beavis is a sincere child who is terrible at lying, and him telling this experience in such detail is one of the factors for it being true. One thing that really pisses me off is people saying things like, Butthead is a bad influence on Beavis, Beavis would be a decent, healthy child without Butthead, Butthead is evil. Dude, like, shut your mouth. Who guarantees that Beavis would really be a normal child without Butthead's influence, just because of that one tiny Christmas special scene? Seriously? We don't even really know Beavis' mindset, because he probably would have suffered that same experience in this universe, or are you going to tell me that the reason Beavis was sexually abused was because of Butthead? Knowing that Beavis has no idea that sexual abuse is something bad and totally worrying, not only for himself, but even for the other people around him. Because sexual abuse can influence a person to have depression, anxiety, irrational fear and guilt, anger, hostility, and age-inappropriate sexual behavior. Butthead presents having the slightest notion that this is a bad thing, but he chose not to get into it in a nosy way. Probably so as not to hurt Beavis emotionally. I think this might be one of the factors for Beavis' somewhat strange behavior. Like hearing voices, having a hyperactive alter ego, and other things. He can even be more aggressive than Butthead himself at times. Ah, the worst is that I have no idea what the point of this video was. I think I just wanted to show some factors of why Beavis has probable indications of mental disorders. Not only the ones that I commented on in the video, but even schizophrenia and autism, which can be worsened by the experience of abuse. But this is up to each person's interpretation, and we can't even say that Beavis really has a mental disorder. But from the reports of several people who have autism and depression and who identify themselves with Beavis, I am pretty sure that Beavis may have some mental disorder. Well, I think I said everything I wanted to say in this video. Not just to talk about this strange scene, but to have a deeper analysis of Beavis' psyche, even though this is just a cartoon of two bastard kids doing shit. I wonder why Mike, creator of the series, did this scene so openly. Maybe this is relevant to the future of the series? Besides the butt, one of the biggest mysteries of the series is knowing the family and the mental state of these characters, but well, that can also be totally irrelevant to the story.